कई दिनों से बारिश होती रही थी, हम कई दिनों से स्कूल जाते रहे थे. Such type of sentences in which the work had started earlier, but it is continued. It is still going on. It was still going on in the past. It is called past perfect continuous tense. Coming to future perfect continuous tense. Future, it means we have to use will and shall. Perfect, it means somewhere we have to use have as well, because in perfect tenses we always use have, has and had. Continuous, it means we have to use ing with verb as well. So together it becomes will have been, shall have been and ing with verb. इन उर्दू सच टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंसेस आर गिवन. वो कई दिनों से मौसम से लुत्फंदोज हो रहे होंगे. कई दिनों से मौसम से लुत्फंदोज हो रहे होंगे. दे विल शोज गा गेगी. दे विल हैव बीन एंजॉइंग वेदर फॉर मैनी डेज. नाउ सी, इन परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूस टेंसेस वी ऑलवेज यूज हैज बीन, हैव बीन एंड हैड बीन. The only difference is that in present perfect continuous tense, we use has been and have been. In past perfect continuous tense, we use had been. And in future, definitely we have to use will and shall. And after will and shall, have been and ing with verb. वो कई दिनों से मौसम से लुत्फंदोज हो रहे होंगे. They will have been enjoying weather for many days. They will not have been enjoying weather for many days. Will they have been enjoying weather for many days? क्या वो कई दिनों से बारिश से लुत्फंदोज हो रहे होंगे? बारिश दो दिन से हो रही होगी, यानी दो दिन पहले शुरू हुई होगी और फिर कहीं जारी होगी फ्यूचर में. इट विल, विल मीन्स गी, गा गेगी. हैव बीन, काम कहीं पहले से शुरू हुआ. आई एन जी विद वर्ब, अब भी जारी है. फॉर टू डेज, विल शोज दैट फ्यूचर में कहीं काम जारी होगा. बारिश दो दिन से हो रही होगी. इट विल हैव बीन रेनिंग फॉर टू डेज. बारिश दो दिन से नहीं हो रही होगी. इट विल नॉट हैव बीन रेनिंग फॉर टू डेज. क्या बारिश दो दिन से हो रही होगी? विल इट हैव बीन रेनिंग फॉर टू डेज. टेक दिस विल आउट ऑफ द सेंटेंस. हेल्पिंग वर्ब्स ऑलवेज कम्स आउट ऑफ द सेंटेंस एंड बिकम्स योर क्वेश्चन एंड इट बिकम्स इंट्रोगेटिव. विल इट हैव बीन रेनिंग फॉर टू डेज. क्या दो दिन से बारिश हो रही होगी? So this is called future perfect continuous tense. कोई काम पहले से शुरू हो चुका होगा लेकिन फ्यूचर में कहीं जारी होगा. Will have been, shall have been and ing with verb. जैसे वो कई दिनों से काम जो है वो पहले से शुरू हो गया, हो रहे होंगे. काम कहीं फ्यूचर में जारी होगा. They will have been enjoying weather for many days. They will not have been enjoying weather for many days. वो कई दिनों से मौसम से लुत्फंदोज नहीं हो रहे होंगे. क्या वो कई दिनों से मौसम से लुत्फंदोज हो रहे होंगे? Will they have been enjoying weather for many days? So this is called future perfect continuous tense. कोई काम पहले से शुरू हुआ होगा लेकिन फ्यूचर में भी जारी है, खत्म नहीं हुआ. Will have been, shall have been and ing with verb. Therefore, this is all about the fourth form of present tense, fourth form of past tense and fourth form of future tense. Fourth form of present tense is present perfect continuous tense. Fourth form, fourth and the last form of past tense is past perfect continuous tense. And fourth form of future tense is future perfect continuous tense. Now, let us do a revision, a brief revision of our tenses at the end. Now, see, I have written all the tenses together. with only same sentence in order to make the difference clear to you. This is present tense. Basic, there are three forms of tenses: present tense, past tense, and future tense. Now see, there are four forms of present tense: present indefinite tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, present perfect continuous tense. Now see, in past tense we have four forms similarly: past indefinite tense, past continuous tense, past perfect tense, past perfect continuous tense. Similarly, in future we have four forms: future indefinite tense, future continuous tense, future perfect tense, future perfect continuous tense. Now see, present indefinite tense, I had already told you the basic identification of this tense is that just after the subject of the sentence you put first form of the verb. This is called present indefinite tense. In past indefinite tense, just after the subject of the sentence you use second form of the verb. It is called past indefinite tense. In future you have to use will, and after will and shall we always use first form of the verb. Will shows that it is future tense, and after will you use first form of the verb. For example, in present indefinite you give me a surprise. Tum mujhe surprise dete ho. You gave me a surprise. Tumne mujhe surprise diya. You will give me a surprise. Tum mujhe surprise doge. This is the difference between these three sentences. Coming to present continuous tense. Now, in present, you have to use helping verbs as is, am, and are, and continuous ing with verb. For example, तुम मुझे surprise दे रहे हो. In present, something is going on. अभी कोई काम जारी है. You are giving me a surprise. तुम मुझे surprise दे रहे थे. You were giving me a surprise. तुम मुझे सरप्राइज दे रहे होगे. यू विल बी गिविंग. एज यू हैव टू पुट आई एन जी विद वर्ब बिकॉज इट इज कंटिन्यूअस टेंस, एंड जस्ट आफ्टर विल डायरेक्टली यू कैन नॉट यूज आई एन जी विद वर्ब. सो विल बी इन फ्यूचर कॉन्टिन्यूअस टेंस, विल बी, शैल बी, एंड आई एन जी विद वर्ब. तुम मुझे सरप्राइज दे रहे होगे. प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट टेंस, कोई काम अभी अभी मुकम्मल हो चुका है. यू हैव गिवन मी अ सरप्राइज, तुम मुझे सरप्राइज दे चुके हो या तुमने मुझे सरप्राइज दे दिया है. पास्ट परफेक्ट, यू हैड गिवन मी अ सरप्राइज, तुमने मुझे सरप्राइज दिया था. यू विल हैव गिवन मी अ सरप्राइज, तुम मुझे सरप्राइज दे चुके होगे. फ्यूचर में कहीं कोई काम हो चुका होगा. यू विल हैव गिवन मी अ सरप्राइज. Present perfect continuous tense. We have just done have been, has been, and ing with the verb. You have been giving me a surprise. तुम मुझे surprise देते रहे हो. शुरू किया था तुमने पहले, लेकिन अब तक वो काम जारी है. You had been giving me a surprise. तुम मुझे surprise देते रहे थे. Past में कोई काम जारी था. Future perfect continuous tense. तुम मुझे surprise देते रहे होगे. You will have been giving me a surprise. You give me a surprise. You are giving me a surprise. You have given me a surprise. You have been giving me a surprise. You gave me a surprise. Past tense, past continuous. You were giving me a surprise. Past perfect, you had given me a surprise. And past perfect continuous, you had been giving me a surprise. Future indefinite, you will give me a surprise. Future continuous, you will be giving me a surprise. Future perfect, you will have given me a surprise. And future perfect continuous, you will have been giving me a surprise. Now see, this is all about the tenses. They are very simple, and it teaches you, once you have understood it properly, then it won't be difficult for you to make a simple sentence in English. Then according to the situation and according to the occasion, it won't be grammatically incorrect, because you know the difference between present, past, and future tenses. Please press the like button. And still, if there is any query, If you need to ask something, you can ask me right in your comments, please. I will happily do it for you again. Thank you so much.